Excellencies, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen. I'm happy to be here today to join in this commemoration of the World Environment Day at the UN. We've just heard from many angles that the impact of human actions on degrading our environment is serious. Our air, our rivers, oceans, forests, rural and urban spaces are being threatened. The survival of a large number of species, including those vital to our own food chain, is under threat. Depleting natural resources are in fact a threat to our own survival in the long run. I come from a country which occupies about 2.4% of the global landmass, 7 to 8% of global diversity of species, and 18% of global population. So you can understand the stress on environment that we face on a day-to-day basis. India has been, in its own way, at the forefront of international efforts to highlight the importance of our environment to life on Earth. And our political leadership has consistently shown commitment to the cause at the global level ever since the 1972 UN Conference on Environment in Stockholm, leading to the final commitment to the 2015 Paris Agreement. India's commitment to green social responsibility stems from a traditional approach and a lifestyle that is rooted in the concept of coexistence of humans with nature. We do not view nature as separate from humans. We see ourselves as part of nature in this grand web of life. Therefore, we were happy to join as the global host of the World Environment Day. This year's theme of Beat Plastic Pollution was our attempt to focus on one area. And I'd just like to mention to you some of the actions that we've taken just in the past 1 week. And these stem from a commitment of our political leadership led by our Prime Minister, who has personally led a campaign for sustainable lifestyles, living in harmony with nature, and improving the cleanliness of our cities and villages. This morning, the Government of India announced a pledge to eliminate by 2022 all single-use plastics in India. Yesterday, we made a commitment that at 100 historic monuments in a radius of 500 meters, including the iconic Taj Mahal, we would ensure litter-free plastic pollution and litter-free areas around those areas. Earlier, a week ago, or a few days ago, the Union Grants Commission, which oversees all Indian universities, has directed all institutions of higher learning in India to stop the use of plastic cups, plastic packaging, plastic bags, disposable food service cups, plates, containers made in polystyrene foam, and plastic straws on their campuses, and restrict single-use plastic water bottles and encourage the use of refillable bottles instead. Now, these are only the most recent instances of government action to focus on the plastic menace in a serious manner. They are only a reflection of the growing stream of environmental consciousness that is reflected in various parts of our civil society. In Kerala, in the southern part of India, fishermen are helping reduce, collect, and recycle plastic. In the northern part, in Uttarakhand, we're turning the tide of plastic pollution through involvement of local communities and business. They are well-known examples of Indian researchers and industry using plastic waste in road construction. And just to indicate to you the dimensions, the fastest road construction anywhere in the world is now being undertaken in India, and part of it is along with use of plastics as an input. In Mumbai, the local community have come forward to undertake huge efforts to clean beaches. Several Indian states have initiated action to replace existing vehicles running on fossil fuels by a fleet of electric vehicles. The Cochin Airport in southern India became the first airport in the world to run completely on solar power. Earlier this month in northeastern India, the Guwahati Railway Station has become the first station in the country to be fully solar powered. Last year, Indian Railway started installing solar panels on their railway coaches. As you can see, it's not only governments, but civil society, corporates, all of them are stepping up to take responsibility for a better and sustainable future. While this plastic menace is the principal focus of our recent efforts, we are acting across a whole host of other areas of environmental interest. For example, a mainstreaming of energy efficiency. Let me just give you an example. The distribution during the last 3 years of 300 million LED bulbs has resulted in savings of US dollars 2 billion and 4 gigawatts of electricity in India. We are also working globally with our partners, and earlier this year we launched what is known as the International Solar Alliance, which brought together more than 45 countries to promote clean, affordable solar energy by mobilizing resources and technology. That number of 45 countries has now risen to 60 countries. We acknowledge that much work remains ahead, both in India and globally, and every action counts as we seek to protect our environment. All of us have a collective responsibility towards this. As part of this collective responsibility, I notice that many colleagues here at the UN are taking different initiatives. This morning, I received a message from one of our colleagues here about how each of the missions can work towards enhancing environmental sustainability. On our part, we too are working in this regard, and we've been working with the UN Secretariat to use renewable energy at the UN premises too. We hope by the next World Environment Day, solar energy will be part of the energy mix used in this building. We from India have made a commitment that we would foot whatever is the bill for that. This is a small contribution that we would like to make towards environmental consciousness at the UN. I'm certain there are many other interesting suggestions that are coming forth, and I'm willing to listen to that. I just thought I will share some of our thinking on this, and I'm grateful to the various UN agencies who are working with this in these collective efforts. Thank you very much for being here today.